Hello again, everybody. I'm Brian Rice, and this is This Week in Tennessee Softball. On this week's show, we catch up once again with Coach Weekly. Tory Lewis takes us out to center field, and we take a look ahead at this week's schedule.
Well, it was a great weekend for us offensively. We really hit the ball well down there, and I think that kind of carried the day. And at times, probably didn't pitch as well as we wanted to. Had some great moments pitching, and then had some innings that kind of got away from us. But I thought Sunday really came out with a very strong performance by Ellen to really close the door. You know, Arkansas is a team that's on a roll. They're one of the hotter teams in the league right now. They took 2 out of 3 from Missouri 2 weeks ago at Missouri, and then they just took 2 out of 3 from Kentucky, another really strong team. So they're playing probably their best softball of the season right now. So we'll have our hands full this weekend. They're doing a little bit of everything right. They're hitting the ball well. They're getting really good pitching out of 3 different pitchers, so that'll be a challenge for us. And they're playing pretty good defense. And they're playing with a lot of emotion, a lot of passion. They're fighting back in games, winning some real close games. So we'll have our hands full, and we'll need to be ready for them. So, you know, we're just doing what we do every week, trying to do everything that we do best and get a little bit better at it, and just stay focused. You know, it was one of those things where at the end of the weekend you went, oh my gosh, Lauren had, you know, all these home runs and all these RBIs and hardly ever made an out, and she was just in the zone. And all through the week, starting with the midweek game, just one of those periods in a hitter's life where they're seeing the ball big and they're just doing the little things right, going up there and controlling the at-bat and picking good pitches to swing at. And it got to the point on Sunday where I was surprised if Ole Miss was ever going to give her a pitch to hit, and they gave her one, and she hit a double, her first at-bat, and then she never saw a pitch after that, 8 straight balls. But she's a tremendous hitter, and she's matured so much as a hitter throughout her career, and it was just nice to see her have that kind of a performance, and truly a once-in-a-lifetime kind of performance. I don't know that in my coaching career I've ever seen anybody have a week like that.
Now that we've caught up with Coach Weekly, let's go out to center field as Tory Lewis gives us a lesson on fielding.
Hi, my name is Tory, and today I'm going to explain to you how to do a drop step. As an outfielder, the reason you use a drop step is to go back on a ball to get a better route and to take a better angle for a ball that's hit over your shoulder. The key with the drop step is to minimize the movements that you make to maximize the amount of ground that you cover. For a ball that's hit over your right shoulder, you want to make sure that you pivot on your left foot and take your right foot to a 45-degree angle. Make sure that your glove is tucked. It's one of the Weekly's biggest pet peeves. And you're going to cross over with your left foot and turn, and then that is when you will start your sprint towards the ball in whichever direction that the ball is hit. Drop stepping from the left side is the exact same, except for you're going to pivot on your right foot and you're going to drop step with your left foot, the 45 degree angle. Be the exact same. Keep your glove tucked and cross over with your right foot and take off sprinting. Thanks for joining me today in learning about the drop step. Remember, the drop step is used for when a ball is hit over your shoulder and you need a more direct route to get to the ball. Go Balls!
Lady Balls host the Razorbacks in a 3-game series this weekend. Friday night's 7 o'clock game can be seen on Sports South. The Razorbacks, new to the top 25 poll, come in to Knoxville ranked 25th in the country. Thanks for joining us for another edition of This Week in Tennessee Softball. Be sure to catch Friday night's game against Arkansas on Sports South and listen all weekend long on the Sports Animal, AM 990 in Knoxville, and online at utsports.com. Join us again here next week for another edition of This Week in Tennessee Softball.